Hello, Girl Bosses. It's another exciting edition of the Girl Boss Girl Talk. I miss you all, my sisters. And on today's edition of the Girl Boss Girl Talk, we're talking about habits of a confident person. And the number one point for today is over-focus on appearance. That's habits of confident people. Confident people don't over-focus on their appearance because they know they are more than their appearance. I'm not saying you're going to look tacky or scattered, but they don't feel like their appearance is all they need to get them places. You know, super vain people and self-conscious people that don't have confidence, they feel like they just need to look good for people to take them seriously. But overly confident people do not need all that. They know they don't need to go overboard. I think that's the proper word to use. To get noticed or to get appreciated. The number two point for today is they don't try to change their personality. If you know anything, you know your personality is you. Forget your face, forget how you look. Your personality defines you. People describe you with your personality. So overly confident people do not try to change their personality. They don't try to become someone else. They're comfortable in their own skin. They be the best version of themselves. You don't try to be like someone else. They try to be like, okay, this is me. This is who I am. I am a naysayer or I am a yesayer. If I say a thing, I do it. That's what confidence people do. You don't try to change their personality to suit people. Because if you change so much, people lose touch of who you actually are. They lose touch of who you actually are, for one. And they cannot really say, okay, this is who this person is. And that's a bad thing. So overly confident people stick to their personality because your personality is you and your personality defines you. Girl bosses, the number three point for today is overly confident people do not chase likes and comments and follows on social media. You know, some people, they need validation from others. Like if they post a photo and they're not getting enough likes on it, they take it down like, oh, that means the photo is not really nice enough. Wow, I mean, you took this photo, you edited it yourself, and you liked it enough, and you posted. Just because people are not feeling it as much as you are feeling it, you take it down. No, girl bosses, you shouldn't do that. If you like a photo, leave it up there. I post photos sometimes, and I'm like, oh my God, I really look cute in this photo. And I end up not getting as much like as I expected. Does that mean I'll take it down? No, I'm going to leave it there because I like the photo, and I like seeing it in my gallery. So you shouldn't chase likes and follows and comments on Instagram or any other social media platform. If you like a thing, do it. Don't do it for the gram. I know some people live for the gram, but life shouldn't be that way. It should be more than the gram or Facebook, as the case may be. Number four points on my list is don't ignore their judgments. And by don't ignore their judgments, I mean when somebody tells you, I don't like the way you smell. I don't like the way you talk. I don't like this about you. I don't like that. Don't shut them up. Don't tell them, yeah, it's not your life, so I'll leave it the way I want. No, don't tell them that. Just allow them. Their opinions, right? Yes. People are entitled to their own opinions. I mean, most of the time, these people do not even know you well. And they just pass judgments and conclude that I don't like you. I don't like this. I don't like that. Please allow them. Your opinions do not matter. Your opinions do not form you. Their opinions do not change who you are. So just allow them. Don't shut them up. Like, shut up. I don't like that. Don't say that about me. You don't know me that way. Don't argue. A confident person does not do that. Oh my God. Just say, okay, that's the way you feel. No problem. You're entitled to your opinion. And then you move. Girl bosses, don't argue with these people because most of them are suckers and they just want to suck you in. Don't get sucked in. Just say, okay, smell and move on. Confident people do not put others down. And what do I mean by not putting others down? Like, they don't shut people up. Like, you're having a conversation and the person's like, you don't know what you're saying, just shut up. Confident people don't do that. They don't shut people up. If you have an opinion, you walk up to them like, oh, I think we should do this way. They'll listen to you because they're confident in themselves. They're confident in their own abilities. They're confident in their own judgment. They'll be like, oh, okay, let's hear you. Confident people, let other people speak. Let's hear other people's opinion because they know they are not perfect and they cannot know it all. It's people that are not confident and they feel like they have a point to prove that. Be like, no, my way is the best. My way is the best. I know it all. Confident people allow you to speak. Confident people are open to ideas. So from now on, if you've always been a person that shuts people up, that's not a confident behavior. Allow people to express themselves. They might actually even have like a better opinion than you do. And we learn every day. Nobody's perfect. Nobody's an island. So be open to learn and be open to hear people out. confident people do not avoid conflicts. I'm not saying they love conflicts, but if you just see conflict, they don't run away from it. They stay there and hash it out. Like somebody saying, I heard this, about me. They'll not be like, oh, it's not true. You didn't hear. They won't. Confident will not be like, I don't care what you heard. Just run along. No, a confident person will be like, oh, you heard about me. I didn't say about you. This is what happened, and then they explain. Do you understand? They don't avoid conflict. I'm like, no, I don't like wahala. It's not about liking wahala. It's about clearing your name and clearing your integrity. So confident people stay and clear their names. I think that's just the best way to explain it. People that are not confident, I'll be like, no, I don't want wahala. I didn't say anything about you. And they move along. The confident person sit down and explain to you like, oh, babe, this is not how it happened. This is how it happened. And this is what transpired. And then they make you feel okay about what happened. So, babe, stop running away from confrontations. Confident people do not clinch to people. And what do I mean by clinch to people? They don't need other people to exist. There's some people that they want to go somewhere. They'll be like, babe, come and follow me now. Come and escort me. You know, I can't go myself. Oh my God, what are you doing, babes? What are you doing? Girl bosses, you should be your own woman. You should be independent to some extent. Don't be like, oh, babe, I want to go to the market. If you don't go with me, I won't go. Babe, in the sense of a girlfriend or a boyfriend. No, you shouldn't be that way. You should be your own girl. You should be your own person. You shouldn't need somebody else, like a support system, to exist. You want to go somewhere, go. You want to do something, do. Don't wait for somebody to accompany you. The last point on today's girl talk, girl bosses, is confident people do not wait for permissions to act. What do I mean? They don't wait for permission to act. Like, okay, they see something wrong. They don't wait for permission to be like, oh, babe, I saw something in your house and I didn't think it was right. What do you think? Do you think I need to do this? No, they see something, they act immediately. They don't need to call like a village meeting just to take a decision. Do you understand my point? Like, oh, somebody messes up with you. You cannot just say, no, I don't like that thing he did. You wait for your tribe to come first before you confront the person. It shouldn't be that way. A confident lady or a confident girl boss that's ready to emerge in 2019 will not do that. They're ready to level up. So, girl bosses, thank you for watching today's video. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. Hit the notification button to get notified every time I post. Till we see you again. I love you all, girl bosses. Big sis loves you. Take care. Bye, girl bosses.